I'm Brian Vann, sportbiketrackgear.com. Today we're going to do a product review on the all-new Alpine Stars Missile Tech Air Compatible Leather Jacket. Okay, the Missile is $599. That's as of the filming of this video. Who is this jacket right for? And this is where this Tech Air Compatible label, I think this can confuse people. Who is this jacket right for? Anybody that's looking for a top shelf, super comfortable, high airflow, ultra badass leather sport bike jacket. That's who this jacket's for. If you're blessed enough that you're able to stack on that Tech Air race system, right? The vest and have the airbag in it, that's additional, right? $1,149. But you don't have to have that for this to be a great jacket. This is a great jacket all by itself. And honestly, there's a lot of ways this thing is better because of allowing for the airbag integration than several of the other jackets on the market today. Let's jump right into sizing. And like we've done with the current crop of Alpine Stars race suits, we're gonna give you a little more detail. We're gonna show you some on-bike stuff just so it's more relative to what you're doing. I'm 5'11" tall, 200 pounds on the money. Waist is between a 32 and a 33 right now. The size that I'm wearing in the race suits, and it's relevant because of the airbag vest gig, is a 56 euro. This missile jacket is a 56 euro. It fits me well if I'm wearing only the jacket without the airbag system in it, right? We're gonna show you all that, me standing there in the jacket, no airbag. Also on the motorcycle, once again, with no airbag. Wearing the same size jacket now with the airbag installed, I have removed the foam back pad that is in the coat to allow for more space. The chest inserts are still installed in the coat. Those could be removed if you wanted to gain just a little bit more volume. At the end of the day, you really should have, and there are some little variables to this, but odds are the size of the jacket, if you're doing a jacket suit combo and repurposing the airbag from one to the next, should be the same size garment. So for me, the 56 works great either way. Okay, now let's do a little bit about how do I feel about it and the features and benefits this thing has to offer. I'm gonna come right out of the gate and say, how do I feel? I love this jacket. The price point's great at $599. A lot of the Tech Air compatible stuff, I'll tell you right now, I believe they're underpricing the garments just a little bit to make it easier for people to stretch and get that airbag, because that's technology they really believe in. It is the owner of the companies. That is his baby. He has worked on this since the first time I met him, probably 10 years ago. Very proud of it. Take advantage of that when you look at these Tech Air garments. You're saving some money, whether you get the airbag or not. The special part of this, right? The thing that makes this the big win, because standalone, it's a great jacket. It's all the stretch panels they have to build in so that it can allow for the deployment of that airbag if you choose to use it and if it ever goes off. Having all those stretch panels makes it better for the rider every day, every ride, because the thing moves on you easier. All this top end four-way stretch up into the chest, how it intersects back here with that huge stretch panel in the back. The little one here in the chest seems small. That's actually a pretty big deal in that spot. Shoulder here, elbow. And there's the real magic right back here. This thing is huge. All connected, all up into the collar, and then it meets with this four-way stretch panel that spans across the top of the back of the shoulders. Moves like second skin. Airbag or no airbag, this jacket is gonna be more comfortable and more mobile than almost any other one on the market today, and that's a big, big benefit. Features, benefits, race-grade armor. This is the same armor that they have in the elbow and forearm and the shoulder of the race suits. We reviewed all those, I took them all apart, same stuff, it's great. Elbow slider, shoulder slider, those are both inlaid. They work with the armor to enhance the protection in that area. Tons of airflow with a perf. There's the indicator light for the Tech Air if you decide to use that. It's got an internal waterproof storage pocket. Once you have the airbag in, right, you are giving up a little bit of access to that kind of stuff. You can see I have the airbag. My airbag's in this right now. You're not going to be able to get to those pockets. You'd have to zip open to be able to get to that. So it's not that big of a deal. Slight inconvenience, but you're picking up so much protection that is a very minor compromise. race grade leather. I really don't have anything that I would rate a takeaway on this coat. I love the coat. I love the ability to install the airbag and the fact that you can use it without it and you still have a cutting edge, best of the best jacket. Now I'm going to show you how to install the TechAir Race Vest into the Alpine Stars Missile leather jacket. It is, of course, TechAir compatible. You can take that race system from your suit, recalibrate it. We're going to show you that in another video, right? Once I get mine all hooked up to the computer, so on and so forth, I'll run you through that. But right now, it's just about how do we get it in the jacket. Of course, this has that integrated back protector as part of the vest. The first thing I'm going to want to do is get in here and remove this foam from the coat. This is going to take up more volume, obviously, and what you don't want to do is overload the coat and make it too tight. So to access this, zip open down here. I want you to reach in. The first thing you have to do is push the wiring harness through. You're going to need that so you can plug it into the vest. We're going to have to pull it back through the other way real quick and make sure that you're careful with this. Do not grab onto the wires and give it a big old tug, okay? Put pressure on the plastic connector itself and manipulate it until you get it to pass through the foam. You don't want to pull the wires loose from the connector. So now you can see I've got that. I'm going to reach in here, get the foam pad out. There's no need for this if you're going to run that TechAir Race Vest. So pull that out, grab your wiring harness. You need to make sure that that passes back through. Okay, you see I've got the harness, has passed back through, okay? Another thing I want to mention, in the chest area of the coat, there are foam pads on both sides. I would try it first with the foam pads in there to see how it fits. The vest does take up some room, of course, just alone, the back protector is thicker than the foam pads, so you have to be cognizant of that. If it's too snug, I want you to zip open this pocket again, reach up in behind the liner, I'll kind of pull it apart a little bit so you can see it. There is the Velcro pocket. You're able to take that chest armor out. Remember, when this thing deploys, it's going to deploy up front too, so the truth is you have some coverage up here. If you do have room for the foam, leave the foam. If you have room, you can also upgrade and put those Nucleon inserts in there and enhance the level of protection even further. Once we're done doing what we're going to do there, zip the pocket back up at the bottom. I need you to, at the neck right here, pull the liner from that Velcro patch right there. Once you've separated that, fold this patch over, connect the liner to the underlying patch, and now you have that flap that's ready to attach to the vest. The vest itself, we're going to start here in the sleeve. There's five Velcro patches and two zippers. Go ahead and pull the one out of the sleeve. You'll see that there is a shape to it that matches the vest. Get that lined up real nice. You want this thing in there as even as possible. So take your time when you're doing this. It's going to have an impact on how it fits inside and feels inside the coat. So this is going to be a spot where you want to take your time a little bit. There's a small circle on the shoulder. Then we come up here to the neck. That lined up nicely and attached. Like so. Other arm. Circle on the shoulder. Okay, now, here are the color-coded zips on the jacket. Let's go ahead and get that zipped up, like so. Now, I'm going to fold this over, grab my wiring harness. Let's turn that so you can see it. plug that in. I'm not going to cover the functionality of this right now. That's an independent video. This is just how to get it into the coat. Go ahead and slide that over. And then zip up the other side of the coat. Very key too to remember when you go from track to street or street to track, it needs to run the other program, street specific or track specific, otherwise it is not going to function properly. That is something you have to do on the PC. We'll show you that later. There you go. It is installed in the missile leather coat. Same one I'm using in my race suit. Here we go, an inside out look, the all new missile tech air compatible leather jacket from Alpine Stars. PE foam padding in the chest. This is one side. There are of course two. This is upgradable to their Nucleon inserts. You'll find those on the website. Comes with a foam back pad. Also, as with the chest, that is upgradable. So you have CE certification in the back. You would only use the back protector insert if you are not running the vest, right? If you're running the Tech Air race vest, you do not need to put a back protector insert in the coat. Elbow and forearm, race grade armor. This is the same stuff you're going to find in their race suit. CE certified, moldable, flexible, comfortable, lightweight. This stuff wears really nice. It's protective, most importantly. CE certified armor in the shoulder, and that works in conjunction with the shoulder sliders that you see on the coat. Those are stitched in, they're inlaid, they work together, tons of protection in that area. Now let's focus on the shell of the jacket itself. Shell of the coat itself, we've got race grade leather here. Just like the race suits right now, in order to accommodate the airbag system, they had to build more stretch panels into the jacket. If in fact there's a deployment, you have to be able to take that volume up. So you look at this coat, look at those massive stretch panels all the way up to the neck from the abdomen area. Stretch fabric here, base of the neck. You can see that nice four-way stretch. Race hump is hollowed out and ventilated for proper exchange of air. Four-way stretch fabric here, volume adjustment, leather, Velcro, metal D-ring. Get to the arm of the jacket, you'll see there's a leather expansion panel here. Leather expansion in the elbow. Elbow slider, that's inlaid just like the shoulder. It's going to work with the armor. There is your indicator light for the Tech Air. We will cover that in another video. Safety strap at the wrist. Comfort fabric. High quality locking YKK zips. Four-way stretch, which is breathable. You'll see they use that all the way from the wrist up into the chest. You'll see how it intersects with a stretch panel back here in the abdomen. Front of the coat, exactly what a leather motorcycle jacket should be, my friend. Perforated to the max, tons of airflow. You add this stuff, it gets warmer for sure, okay? When you do put the airbag vest in there, it does block some of this. You're still going to get a lot of good air exchange and cooling here in the outer arms in regions where the vest is not covering. And then remember, even with the race hump, that allows air to flow in and out of the coats. So they've done things to compensate for some of the perforation being blocked by having the vest. The collar, we've got some stretch fabric right up here. That's once again, that's for airbag deployment too and comfort. Hand warmer style storage, both sides with quality YKK zips. Get inside the coat. This does not include any type of vest warming liner, removable full body and sleeve liner. It does not have that, doesn't need it. This is meant for warm weather riding. Full circumference, zip to pants. If you want to use a pair of the Alpine Stars missile pants, get a two-piece gig out of this, you can do that. Storage pocket here on the left side, that is waterproof. Storage on the right side, not waterproof, Velcro closure. If you want to run one of the A-Stars back protectors without, once again, the airbag vest, you have their snap connection point here. If you want to use that, that is a feature they build in. To access any of the armor, there is a zip pocket right here. So if you need to get into the internal armor, remove the back pad, chest armor, elbow, forearm, shoulder. Zip this open. You have full access here. It also helps when retrieving the airbag harness if you're going to use that feature with this jacket. What do I think? Like I said before, absolutely amazing. Standalone at $599. This is one of the best sport leather jackets you're ever going to slide on over your shoulders. Whether you want the airbag or not, this thing is one hell of a buy. You'll love it.